Hey, what's going on, peeps? This is Rex, and I'm going to give you every secret in the world of Lords of the Fallen. The first secret, and by far the most important one, is a secret door at the very beginning of the game. To open the door, you must first find the key. You can see here where to get the key. This is also at the beginning of the game before you finish the tutorial section of the game right after you kill the first boss. Now with the key, head back to the first room where you started the game. You will see this innocent looking balcony. You can actually jump in there and find a secret hallway. In there, you will find a door that your newly acquired key opens. And in said room, you will find a Shard of Heroes. The Shard of Heroes is a magnificent item that will allow you to do one of two things. It'll either grant you a massive bonus of experience and a strong weapon, or it will allow you to respect your class. If you go into the Square of Heroes after you defeat the commander and talk to the statues, you'll get the option to respect your class, useful for New Game Plus if you want to mix things up. If you, however, talk to the statues in the middle of the commander encounter or the beast encounter, the boss will break the statue that you talk to, and the statue will reveal a secret item that you'll be able to collect for yourself. The act of doing this will grant you a tremendous amount of experience. I will not recommend doing this early game as it'll grant you at least 5 or 6 levels and it'll make you way stronger than what you're supposed to be, but I can't stop you either. Saving the injured monk will allow you to talk to him again in the Citadel and accept a quest from him. A quest that'll allow you to give him the Tyrant Hearts that you will be collecting later on in the game. In exchange, he will reinforce your potions so that they heal you better, kind of like reinforcing your Estus flasks in Dark Souls. The flint allows you to burn the bonfire, which not only gives you a nice boost of experience, but will give you extra reinforcements at the Citadel the first time you pass through. Very useful. You can also drop yourself at the back of the tower to get a free empty bottle and a weapon. By the checkpoint after the commander, if you go straight through a bunch of enemies to what seems to be an empty room with a door you can't open, you can use your shield ram ability to break a secret wall to get a weapon. Inside the Citadel, in the room with all the injured warriors, you can break a wall to get a nice heavy armor set. In here you can get the hammer Tor, a very easy to miss hammer that happens to have a secret use. You can use this hammer to destroy the 4 statues that are scattered through the Chamber of Lies and the Bridge Between Worlds. Every destroyed statue will yield you a piece of the Last Traitor set, a very cool looking set of armor. After the Lost Quarters, after you defeat the Lost Brothers, you can find a short sword named Curse. The Curse has a hidden use. If you take it to the graveyard, you can choose to bury it in the grave to fight a ghost. If you win the fight, you can pick up the sword again, except that it'll be improved this time with more magic damage. The same can be told about the Hammer Heirloom. To get it, go to where the cells are in the catacombs. The 11th cell will hold an enemy. After you kill it, you will notice some vines and a weakened wall behind the vines. You can destroy this wall to uncover the secret Hammer Heirloom. The hammer has another hidden property, however. You can take it to the mines below the catacombs and put it on a grave. If you do, the hammer will come out improved. This is an important item, since it is one of the only items in the game that has lightning damage, which you can then use to deal the finished blow to the Annihilator to get his special weapon. The only other weapon that can do this is Unity, which happens to be another secret weapon. To get Unity, you need to get both parts of the staff. The staff hilt is easily gotten by opening a rune locked door in the Chamber of Lies. You will most probably get it just by playing the game normally. The head is a little bit more difficult. You will need to have already activated the shortcut from one side of the chamber to the other by using both levers to kill the Annihilator. From this side of the chamber, activate the lever and without leaving the zone, go to the other side to get the now open door to get the staff's head. With both parts collected, head over to this side of the Chamber of Lies. Jump the pit and this innocent looking door shall open for you. Unity will be in the chest. The thing that the champion stabs is actually the boss Beast. The closed off room in there is actually the jail of this monster. After you fight and kill Beast, you can come back here and find this room forcibly opened. You can loot the chest inside for an empty bottle and a bunch of lore scrolls. After defeating the Lost Brothers, you can find another breakable wall right before entering the Citadel. You can use the clone ability to press the pressure plate and get into the now open door, inside the newly discovered room. This trick can also be used on the next pressure plate in the Citadel found at the Planetarium to get the Blessing Armor set. A breakable wall can be found at the tutorial section right at about where you find the key to the Shards of Heroes. This place is the cellar, but it is super high level though, so don't go in there if you're just starting. Now, before we finish, the special requirements for every boss for you to get the special version of the weapons that they drop. For the first warden, you need to kill him without getting hit. For the commander, kill him without blocking with either a shield or your weapon. Do not block at all. For the inquisitor, have him kill at least 2 of his own minions. For the infiltrator, kill him before all the braziers are lighted. For the champion, kill him without enraging him. He's scripted to enrage every time you drop a bar, but those ones don't count. For the beast, kill him without stepping into any of his poison pools. For the garden, kill him without turning off any of the cauldrons. And lastly, for the annihilator, do the killing blow with an electric weapon. If there's something cool you guys found out that is not in this video, please write it in the comments so we can all just know a little bit more about this awesome game. But dudes, this has been Rex with all the secrets for Lords of the Fallen. Have a great day.